panels are a versatile product and can be used for a variety of applications, such as doors, desktops, dividers, and more. With nearly 100 panel options, there's a lot to consider, including purpose, stability, and size of the panel you'll need. 8020 offers a variety of panels to choose from. The most popular are wire mesh, aluminum composite, and acrylic, each one with a different purpose and appearance. The purpose of your panel is the number one factor to keep in mind. Will your panel be inside or outside? Will it function as a door or a tabletop? Whatever the purpose might be, 8020 has plenty to choose from for a variety of project needs. For example, if you're using a panel as a tabletop, some common choices include our phenolic resin panels for desks or tables, or ABS hair cell for something like a workstation. If you're building a light door, you might consider polycarbonate or acrylic. Once you've determined the purpose, stability is the next element to consider. Several options are available to hold the panel in place within the T-slot. For wire mesh panels, you can use wire mesh retainers to lock the panel in place. As for acrylic and other solid panels, you can choose retainers or gasket to reduce noise and vibration. Another option is panel mount blocks, which allows the panel to be mounted flush with the profile. The third element to consider is the size of the panel. If you're going to insert a panel into the T-slot channel, you should plan for extra material in addition to the actual size of the panel that will be visible. We also suggest planning notches into the design so your panel will easily fit into the T-slot. Having extra gasket on hand can also be helpful to reduce noise from vibration. When it comes to ordering panels, you must include a drawing to indicate orientation. Mesh panels should have a specified orientation since they can be used in either direction. For example, with expanded metal, it can be used in a vertical or a horizontal orientation. Panels like ABS hair cell have a smooth side as well as a textured side. The outward side of the panel must be specified with a labeled texture. Another item to include in your panel drawing is a machining reference. Label your panel in a standard format, beginning at the top left corner in a counterclockwise order, and reference the callouts when ordering machining on your panel. Now that we've explored the main considerations to keep in mind when choosing your panels, are you ready to start designing? We hope you found this segment on panels helpful. For more information, please visit 8020.net. When you subscribe to our channel, you can expect to see more inspiration for your future projects.